7月第一个星期是全国钓鱼周， Lake Simcoe 水警联合约克景区向钓鱼者和游湖游客宣传安全注意事项。 Lake Simcoe 水警表示，初夏的湖水仍然很凉，中午的气温虽然达到摄氏20多度，但湖水的温度不到摄氏10度，不小心落水的话，身体就会像被棒球棒击中一样，很容易还没有反应过来就已经抽筋下沉，因此穿着救生衣非常重要。一般水上活动穿着的个人浮水装置与救生衣同样有令人浮在水面的功能，也必须确认的是获联邦交通部认可的型号。个人浮水装置较轻便，落水后会自动膨胀，非常方便水上活动。救生衣的设计是胸前加厚，确保穿着的人落水后脸部保持向上。约克区警方提醒公众，市民切记进行任何游览活动前应先评估活动的危险性，对自己的安全负责。
今天我们是第二天，我们这个呢是一个叫做 Water Safety Initiative， 是我们约克区警察局那个 Diversity and Cultural Resource Unit 和 Marine Unit 一起合作，今天做的一个活动。我们从 Diversity Unit 过来的话呢，有我自己，还有我的同事那个周警官在这里，还有那个阿丽兰，那里是我们另外一个同事，同时那个 Marine Unit 这边有 Sergeant Sato。 我们今天的目的呢，会出到湖上去宣传那个钓鱼和那个划船的安全。这个星期的话呢，是安省的钓鱼周，所以就是说大家出来钓鱼的话呢，这个星期不需要渔证，所以很多从城市里面来的人呢，平时一般都是大家忙都不会过来，但是就是天气好，夏天就过来钓鱼，但是就是注意那个钓鱼安全、划船安全方面就没那么注意。我们今天主要就是宣传，然后给大家老生常谈的再多说一说钓鱼安全。另外的话，我们今天会给这个宣传册，上面主要讲划船出海的那个必备，这是一个中文的版本。待会儿我们如果碰到呢说中文的那个钓鱼或者划船的人，我们会跟他有积极的互动，然后宣传一下钓鱼安全。
那这个活动每年都会展开一次吗？
差不多每年都会展开，因为一般的是这个时候的话呢，夏天马上来嘛，然后夏天我们就主要就说比较积极的多做一点那个 proactive 的那个叫做什么宣传。冬天的话我们也会有，冬天因为这个湖上那个 Lake Simcoe 冬天会有很多人搞冰钓，就是 ice fishing， 然后因为这个湖会结冰，还有很多人甚至可以开着车到湖上去，然后钻个孔钓鱼。其实这个呢也有很多，就说也要注意安全，因为这个冰有时候不那么结实的话，有时候情况不好的话还会有这种事情，车人都掉下去的也都有。
那平常在这个湖面上都会有警察巡逻吗？
有，我们警察，我们那个约克区的水警是在这里，夏天是船上，冬天是那个还有个 airboat， 我们也有那个 ATV 和那个 Sea-Doo 那种摩托艇一样的，都有。
Yes, it's Constable Gould, with York Regional Police Marine Unit.
Okay, and can you tell us a little bit about your duty and the Marine Unit?
So, as part of the Marine Unit duties, we are out on Lake Simcoe and the other waterways in York Region, and we provide enforcement, education, and then other services on the water as far as providing safety information to people using the waterways in the winter and the summertime. What we see is some people are obviously going out on the water in different types of vessels, and they're not looking to make sure that they're carrying the proper safety equipment on board for the type of vessels that they're choosing to operate. So it is important that if they do choose to operate a motorized vessel, that they have a pleasure craft operator card, that the vessel is registered to them, and that they have all the proper safety equipment that they are required for that size of boat they choose to operate. Typically for the fishing people, a lot of them do comply with the fishing regulations and having the proper licensing for that. Anyone that is over 65 years of age does not require to have a fishing license in Ontario if they're an Ontario resident. This week especially, it's a province-wide fishing weekend or fishing week where they do not require a license to fish, so that's a good opportunity for people to go out. And with fishing itself, it's good to let people know where you're going and what time you're expected back if they're going out on the water, or especially being out on a boat, and then understanding that there are specific regulations to specific species of fish that they're looking to catch or possess. So they have to look at that and understand that there's different species and different catch limits for those different types of fish. So basically in the summertime, we find ourselves out on Lake Simcoe mostly, but we do have Lake Wilcox and Musselman's Lake that we patrol as well. And we'll go out and generally stop vessels that are having problems, that have broken down, and we'll try and render assistance to them. We also provide enforcement, so we'll stop vessels and check them for safety equipment and documentation. With that, we also provide search and rescue. So if someone becomes lost out on the lake, or say their vessel overturns, and or simply the fact that someone hasn't returned on time and a loved one on shore is calling to report them overdue, we'll provide a service of going out and looking for that person until we find them.
It's pretty simple. First of all, the most important thing is that everybody's wearing a PFD. With this particular PFD, it's a manual inflate. So this little tab, in the event that you have to get off of the vessel, you pull this tab and this actually inflates. And it inflates like a life jacket, and this particular PFD will actually keep your head above the water, and it'll keep you floating upright like this. Typical PFDs that are vest styles, I don't have one to show you here, but they don't keep your head above water. Sometimes if you lose consciousness, you can actually float like this. It'll keep you above the water, but it won't keep your head above the water. This one, as long as it's inflated, will keep your head above the water and your airway free of water so you can breathe. Other than that, when you're on the vessel, at all times, keep a hold of something. The boat, we might have to make a sudden turn or a sudden stop. Whenever you're on the boat, just hold on to something. Keep a hold of it, especially your camera people. Just make sure they're holding on to something so they don't fall. Other than that, if you want to come into the cabin, there's a few items in here. In the event of an actual vessel fire, we have fire extinguishers, and then we also have a fire suppression system for the engine compartment. In the event of a fire, just listen to the instructions of the operator or one of the crew, myself or Matt. Other than that, we have a life raft on board as well. In the event that we have to leave the vessel, we'll deploy a life raft. We've also got life rings and throw ropes as well. The most important thing is just have a hold of something in the boat and then listen to the instructions of, the operator or the crew. And that's about it.
What happened in the event of nighttime?
Operations? Yeah. Nighttime operations for us or for other people?
For you guys. Yeah.
For us? Well, our boat's fully equipped with, in terms of a search and rescue at nighttime, if we're operating at night and we're looking for something, we have spotlights, we have thermal imaging, we also have night vision monoculars, and for vessel operation and navigation, we have a chart plotter, we have radar, and he's just pulling up the thermal imaging camera. So we have all the necessary equipment to navigate at nighttime, and to search at nighttime in the event that we're looking for a vessel or somebody in the water.
Mm-hmm. So if people fall in the water during nighttime, what should they do usually?
Well, hopefully, one, they have a PFD or a life jacket on. At nighttime, that's why we always, for safety equipment on board of a vessel, you're supposed to have a flashlight, a waterproof flashlight in the vessel. So in the event that your vessel sinks or something, you do have a flashlight with you. If the vessel doesn't sink, you always stay with the vessel, and then you can actually use the flashlight to try to signal for help. And if we're out on the water, if we see a light, we'll more than likely go investigate what that light is out in the middle of the lake. Sorry? Oh, now the FLIR. That's our thermal imaging unit. And that picks up a sea heat signature out on the water. So if there is somebody floating out there, within a certain distance, we'll be able to pick up their heat signature out on the water. The water is colder, and this profile of somebody above the water
will be able to pick up the heat from their head above the water.
Okay. And I see you're giving a whistle to
yeah.
people. What is that doing?
For us, we always recommend it's on one vessel. You could have, like, here we have 68 people on the boat, but you're only required by law to have a signaling device on the vessel, one. But what we recommend is that everybody carry a whistle attached to their PFD, which they should have on like us, and have a whistle attached to that PFD. That way, if you fall into the water, especially at nighttime, you're able to signal for help. The whistle's obviously very loud, a P-less whistle.
感谢收看今天的大多故事，我们下期再见。